Good morning, students of KTech High School and Junior College. So, today we are going to take which subject? English. Okay, we are going to do English. And in English, this English is of class 7. Which standard? 7th standard we are doing. Okay, and in this we are going to do lesson 3.6. Can you see? Yes, we are going to do lesson 3.6. Think before you speak. And this will be our first explanation part. Okay. And student, can you see in the picture? What can you see? Yes, a girl, she is thinking. Okay. And two person, they are having a talk. Now, from this heading on itself, what can you understand? Yes, you have to think before we speak. So, student, I'll just give you a small introduction of this lesson. Okay? Now, think before you speak. Now, it carries an advice that we should refrain over here means stop oneself from using such words which we will have to regret. Regret means feel sad or disappointed later. Okay, while having a conversation or having a talk between two person, the word should be used properly. Otherwise, regret means afterwards, we don't have to feel disappointed or feel bad about it. Okay, student? Got? Okay. Understood this? Yes. Now, see. Some says are there. Okay. Now, think. What is the full form of think? See. T, it stands for truth. See, while speaking, students, you have to speak truth. Okay. Means true, you have to speak. Now, H is for it is helpful. Okay, when you speak truth, it helps us. We don't get caught. Okay, got this? Now I, it stands for inspiring. Inspiring means okay, you have said, so we can say okay, we can get an excuse. If we tell false, what happens? We got caught now. Yes, so every time speak the truth. Okay. And N is necessary. When we need anything, need a holiday or want to go somewhere, so you have to speak truth. Means you have to speak true. And K, it is for kind. See, all these four things are then that person, he feel kind of you. He forgives you. Okay, student? Or he tells, okay, you can have a leave like that. It can be kind to you. Okay, student, got this? So every time while speaking, you have to speak truth. First of all, think properly and then speak out. Okay, what we are saying. Got, student? Now let's see this lesson. This great person, Benjamin Disraeli, okay, He's saying something about this lesson. Okay, we'll read the lesson and we'll get the point. Now, this Benjamin Disraeli, when he was born on December 21st in 1804 in London. And he died when? In April 1881 at the age of 76. And where did he die? In London only. Okay, student? I'm just giving a short born and death count. Okay, we'll see the lesson, what he wants to convey. Okay, what he want to tell us. Okay, student. So, student, open your book to page number 75. Okay, have you opened your book to page number 75? Yes. Now, What are you going to do? You are going to put your fingers on the line while I am reading. Okay? You will get interest in this reading. Okay, student? While explaining, while reading, you will get interesting. And the lesson is also very beautiful, how he said. Okay? Shall I start? Open everyone? Okay. Put your fingers on the line. Okay? Now, lesson 3.6. Think before you speak. First, I'll read the lesson. Okay? Not the whole lesson, only one page. Okay, student? Because this is a part one. Okay? So, shall I start? Okay. Man was meant to listen more and talk less. That is why, as the great British statesman Benjamin Disraeli said, nature have endowed. Now see, endowed means what over here? Underline this word and write down the meaning. Endowed means provided or given. Okay? Provided or given. What nature has endowed. Endowed means given. Nature has given man what? With two ears and one mouth. See, what has God given us? Two ears and one mouth. If man was meant to talk more and listen less, he would have two mouths and only one ear. Imagine how we would have looked. How strange with two mouths on the two sides and one ear at the center. Okay? And mind you, the ears are like funnels, open all the time. There is no door with which you can close them. Whereas, if you have to speak even one single word, that word must pass through two walls, that is two fences. There is firstly the fence of these two rows of teeth, yes, and the secondly the fence of the two lips. Before a word can be spoken, it has to pass, it has to pierce through these two walls. Now, underline this pierce. Pierce means go through. Go into, through this two walls. Okay? Through these two fences. Therefore, we must think at least twice before we utter a word. Next, a wise man once remarked that of the unspoken word, you are a master. Of the spoken word, you are a slave. Once you have spoken a word, you cannot get it back. Do what you will. Therefore, you must be very careful about the word that you speak. Once the word has left your lips, you will not be able to get it back. What unspoken word? There are things you want to say but remain unsaid, as though in our mind. Once you have put the thoughts into words, once the word left your lip, you cannot change them or control them. A young man went to his spiritual teacher and said, I have spoken very harsh and unkind words to my friend and he is deeply hurt. I am afraid of having lost my friendship with him. How can I make amends? Now underline this amend. Amend means make up for the wrong thing that has been done. What is the meaning of amend? Amend means made up of for the wrong that has been done. Okay, student. Now I shall be reading one paragraph and I will be explaining you with the help of the what? Picture. Yes. Okay, student. Now let's start. Now the first paragraph. See nature endowed us with 2 ears plus 1 mouth is equal to what? We have to listen. Yes. See down only. We have 2 ears and 1 mouth. So that we can listen twice. Yes, we can listen twice now through our 2 ears as much as we speak. We speak so much. So listening also should be there. Okay. And what else? See, God gave us 2 ears also and 1 mouth for some reason. He has given us for some reason. If these 2 things were not there, then what would have happened? Just imagine. Okay, just think. And what else I'm... Yes, over here. Cough fraud. What he's telling? We've got 2 eyes, 2 ears and 1 mouth. So, we should use them in this proportion. Yes, we can... We have to use our words in good proportion. As we hear, as we see, so we have to speak also how less. Okay, got this? Yes. Now, and see, what the second paragraph is saying. See, and mind you, the ears are like funnels, open all the time. Yes, our ears, they are open, isn't it? Do our ears have a door? No, there is no doors for ear. It is open, isn't it? Yes. There is no door with which you can close them. Can we close our ear? No, never. Whereas, if you have to speak even 1 single word, that word must pass through 2 walls. Now, over here, in our face, on our face, which are the 2 walls? Okay. Means 2 fence. Fence means how we put a compound to our land, huh? Like that. Even we have a fence. Now, which are those fence? We'll see. Okay. There is firstly the fence of this 2 rows of teeth. Yes. See, can you see? 2 rows of teeth. That is our first fence. Means this tongue is inside this fence. While speaking, we have to touch our tongue to the teeth, then only we can speak. Now without touching, can you speak? Just try and tell me. Okay, this is our first row, first fence. Now let's see the second fence. We have got 2 fences, isn't it? So let's see the second fence. What happens over here? The second fence of the 2 lips. Yes, while speaking, first our tongue, it touches the teeth. Without touching the teeth, we cannot speak out, isn't it? Yes. And after that, to remove that word, we have to touch the second fence, that is our lips. Okay, then only we can speak, na? Yes. Now, before a word can be spoken, it has to pass it through this 2 walls. Yes, this proceed through this 2 walls. They have to be passed through this 2 wall, that is our teeth and the lips. Okay, therefore we must think at least twice before we utter a word. So before uttering a word, we have to think twice. Just you don't have to buckophile. Just talk. Even God have told us that you have to listen carefully, see good things and speak less. Over here also, see the great statement that Benjamin, even he's telling us that you have to think twice and then speak out. Okay, just see, I'll show you the picture. See, this is our ear. Does the ear have any door? No. See, English is in English you can have maths, geography, history, science. See, science have also come in English. All subject is related to this English. Okay, now see, in this ear, can you see a door? No. See, the outer part is the pinna. Okay, the ear I'm explaining you, it is a pinna. The line, can you see the ear canal? From there we can hear, and it passes through that canal. Okay, then it goes to the eardrum. Eardrum is there? Yes, it passes through eardrum. And where does it go? It goes to the middle ear. Okay, after middle ear, where does it go? To the inner ear. Okay, can you see how it is passing through the inner ear? Then it comes to the tube. Okay, this, it is passing. Does it have a door? No, it doesn't have a door. But what we are listening, it passes through all these channels. Okay, it has, then only we can hear, and it goes and get touch with our mind. Over there we start thinking, isn't it, student? Yes. Okay, this is our ear and the words which are passing through it, through this channels I've shown you. Okay, now, and it is a funnel like. Can you see this funnel? It is open. Does this funnel have a door? Is it closed? No, we can't close this funnel. Can we close? In the same way, can we close our ears over here? There is any door over here? No, we can't close them. Okay, as this funnel is not closed, our ear is also not closed. It is open every time. Okay, it is open all the time. And see, from which two fences? This is the first fence, and the second fence is, yes, over here. There's two fences. Now, the first fence is, you have to, it will touch what? The first, it will touch your teeth. Yes, over here. The first fence is a teeth, the tongue. It will touch the teeth, and then what happens? The word is coming out from your lips. Got? Getting lips and this teeth. These are a funnel. Fences. Okay, these two are our fences. Okay, got this? The word should be passed through these two fences. They are called as a two wall. Okay, so before speaking out, what you have to do? You have to think. See, over here, while speaking, see how she's talking? Can you see? Yes, she's laughing also. So, you have to speak nicely. Okay, first you have to think before you speak. Then you speak out. See, she might have thought something and she has spoken out. So, that's why she's starting laughing. Some nice joke or something might have happened. So, she is laughing also, isn't it? And the second person, how she's just listening, isn't it, in a good manner. She's in a good mood also, and she's listening to her. Okay, got? So over here, the word which have been uttered might be good word, isn't it? That's why they are laughing, they're chatting, isn't it? Okay, got, student? Got till here? Now let's go to the next paragraph. A very wise man once remarked that of the unspoken words, you are a master. Now, what is this unspoken words, you are a master? Now, see, student. Unspoken means when we have not spoken anything till that time, we are the master of those words. That are, those words are with us only. So, we are the masters of those words. Okay, and once that word is spoken out, when that word is spoken out, so we becomes a slave. Yes, at that time we become a slave. got student? See, unspoken means we are just thinking that I'm going to tell now. But that till we have not spoken. So till that time we are the master of those words. Okay. And once that word are spoken out from our mouth, so we become slaves. Okay. So once you have spoken a word, you cannot get it back. So when you speak out, can you get the word back? Can you get them back? No, it is not possible. For example, I'll tell you. Now everyone know bow and arrow, isn't it? Bow and arrow. In Hindi, teer and what we say, teer and ban. That once the arrow is thrown out from the bow, will that arrow come back? If you tell a arrow come back, will it come back? No. Same way, once the word are spoken out, we cannot get it back. Okay. What you will do? Can you do anything? No. Therefore, you must be very careful about the words that you are speaking. Yes. We in our group, we speak anyhow. We just go on speaking. We just don't see the intention of the other person. We just buckle file. But afterward, some word might be said in such a way that the person who is listening, sometime he may got hurt also. He or she may get hurt also. We don't see that. We just go on speaking. Isn't it, student? So it is a bad manner to speak too much. Okay. So once the word has left your lips, see over here also, once the word has left your lips, you will not be able to get it back. Once whatever you have said, can you get it back? When you can you tell those words that come back and go into my mouth? Can you tell that? No, it is not possible. How can the word come? Afterwards, what you feel? You feel sad. We'll see in the next paragraph. Okay, just see over here. This wise man. Okay. Got this wise man? Yes. He's thinking and he's telling that, see, once the word have been said out, you will be the slave. Okay. What are you going to be? You'll be a slave over here. Okay. And what happens? You have to speak how? In a good way, so that the person, she feels good. Okay. She feels good. You should not hurt the person. Okay. You should not hurt that person. Got student? Now let's see the third. So be careful who you push away. Real ones don't come back. Yes, what you are saying, that words, they don't come back. Okay, student? Yes. How you are speaking? Through this fences. Okay, once the word has gone, you will not get it back. Okay, student? Now let's see. What are unspoken words? What are unspoken words? They are things you want to say. See, what are the unspoken word? Unspoken word means they are in your mind only. You have not said anything. You want to say, but you are not able to say those words. That remains in your mind only. Okay, and you want to say, but remains unsaid. But you are not able to say those words. As thoughts in your mind, those word remains in your mind as a thought only. Okay, you just go on thinking, I want to say this word, but you don't get time. So those word remains in your mind as a thought only. Okay, once you have put the thought into words, yes, when those words come on your lips, See, once you have put the thoughts into words, the thoughts which are in your mind, they come into your lip. It comes on your lip and words have left your lips. Those words which are in your thought, they comes on your tongue and they are said, are left through your lips. Those words are left through your lips. You cannot change them or control them. Can you change them once the word are said? No, you can't change them or you cannot control them. But a young man went to his spiritual teacher and said, I have spoken very harsh and unkind words to my friend and he is deeply hurt. I am afraid I may lost my friendship with him. How can I make amends? So what happens? A young person, a young man or a young child, he goes to his spiritual teacher. Now spiritual teacher means what? A good teacher means who have got knowledge of everything. Okay, spiritual means well-known teacher. God, he goes to that teacher and he tells her or him that I have spoken very harshly. Harshly means I've spoken unwanted words. Now, and unkind words. Unkind means unwanted words. Now, to whom? To his friend. And he got deeply hurt. Now, he's feeling hurt. The words which I've said to that friend. Now, that friend is feeling very bad. Now, and I'm afraid also. And he's telling that, see, enough and I've said everything. But now I'm afraid that my friendship may be broken. Lost means broken. And how can I amend my friendship? So, over here, how can I make my friendship again? Will it be possible? How can I do it? So, he's going and asking to his spiritual teacher. Okay, students, see, I'll show you. Picture here. See, he's going to his teacher and he's talking that I've said my friend unkind words. Okay, now he's not talking to me. He's feeling hurt. He's feeling sad. He's not talking to me. What should I do? So he's going and asking his teacher. See over here, they're having a talk from this friend. One friend, he's not he's feeling deeply hurt. The words which are said, the words which are said might have been hurted him. So he's feeling bad. And the person who said, even he's afraid that his friendship may break. Yes, his friendship may break. Okay, student. So while speaking, students, you have to think. It might happen with you also that your friendship might have been broken. Now, so to get your friendship again, you have to speak properly, truth. You have to be kind to her. You have to speak nicely to her. All these things, you have to do it again if you want your friendship. So, student, while speaking only, think many times what we are speaking, what we want to speak, what we want to say. Think many times. Then only remove the words from your fences. Which are two fences? The teeth and the lips. Okay, student? Okay? Understood? Okay. Thank you, students.